In today's video, we'll learn how to make your video more accessible to more people by adding closed captioning to it directly in Final Cut Pro. Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome back to my channel for another Final Cut Pro tutorial. In Apple's latest Final Cut Pro update, they've added the ability to add captions to your video. Captions are used primarily for closed captioning for the hearing impaired. They can also be used for subtitles, karaoke, scrolling news items, and so on. Final Cut Pro now gives you the ability to add captions to your project right in the project timeline. Let's take a look at how we can do it. First thing you have to do is choose your captions format. This depends on your delivery requirements. For broadcast, web streaming, DVD, or Blu-ray, choose the CEA 608 format. If you're building your project for delivery to the iTunes store, then select ITT format for your captions. Next, you need to add a captions role to your project. From the menu bar, select Modify, Edit Roles, and select the Captions tab. By default, Final Cut Pro suggests an ITT captions role, which is much more feature-rich. But if you want to use the more universally compatible CEA 608 format, you first have to remove the ITT role by clicking the minus button beside it. Next, click the plus button on the right-hand side and select CEA 608. Click Apply to close the roles window. Now you're ready to add captions to your project. Down in your timeline, set the playhead where you want to add your caption. Now from the menu bar, select Edit, Captions, and Add Captions. Final Cut Pro places a caption clip in the caption lane, and the caption editor opens up in your timeline. Type your text into the caption editor. To view your caption in the viewer, from the View drop-down menu, select Show Captions. The caption clip can be moved or modified just like any other clip in your timeline. Ripple trim the start and end of your clip to adjust the timing. To add another caption clip, move your playhead, select Edit, Captions, and Add Caption, or to save time, use the keyboard shortcut Option C. Type in your next caption, and click anywhere outside the caption box to close it. To modify your captions, double-click on the caption clip in your timeline. You can modify the text directly in the caption editor, or modify other parameters in the inspector. To change the placement of your caption, use the arrows below the text box. Under that, you can modify the display style, formatting, text color, text background opacity, and text background color. As you add captions to your project, Final Cut Pro automatically checks your captions for errors. Captions with errors appear red in your timeline. For example, if you overlap your caption clips, the affected clips will appear red in the timeline. An explanation of what's causing the error and possible solutions appear in the captions inspector. If you have caption errors in your timeline, Final Cut Pro will not let you share your project without first resolving the caption issues. If you don't resolve the caption issues, Final Cut Pro will export your video without captions. To export your video with embedded captions, simply share your project just like you would any other project. Your viewer will have the ability to turn the captions on and off when viewing your project. You can also export your captions as a separate add-on file when exporting your project. In the Share window, select the Roles tab, and select the Export Each Subrole as a Separate File checkbox. An additional captions file will be exported alongside with your video file. These files can be useful for sharing services that require you to upload an additional captions file when uploading your video. Adding captions to your next project will help you reach a much wider audience. The ability to do this directly in Final Cut Pro is, in my opinion, a very welcome update. Do you ever turn on captions when watching videos? Let me know in the comments below. If you're new here, make sure to check out the rest of my channel for more Final Cut Pro tutorials. New videos release weekly, so make sure you hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss them. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next time.